Number two, Alvy. Number seven for Alvy. We're missing two players. They did not want to play. Michael Phillips. Number six, which leaves Sewa Naka, number one. Matches are Saywan versus Ricky, David Rothel, Chris McKenna, Louis Irossi, Michael Phillips, Alvy and Ben Noonan.
Thank you. there, Jake?
I was pretty keen to see teams on the floor, but nah.
Thank you. 15.
Yeah, I can fly now. Nice. I don't know what.
Let's go.
Right.
but it will be on table three. Tables were allocated before the draw was done. Good luck to everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Cubal TV here at the Empire Johnny Walker Classic semi-final stage. Ben Noonan versus Dave Rothel and Luigi, I can't pronounce his surname, against Ricky Emery. And I'm here in the commentary box with Linda Holly, the Australian ladies captain. No?
Vice captain.
Australian ladies vice captain. And she gave me a touch up in the group stages. She got lucky though. And what's your predictions, Linda?
It's hard to say. Obviously, they've all played really well today. And that is Luigi Iorossi for those people.
Iorossi.
I'll pronounce the name. Probably can't understand Roman anyway.
It's an Irish surname, I think.
Obviously, Ricky Emery is in form after winning Barry.
Yeah.
Guy doesn't play hardly at all anymore. He's still a freak.
He spent the whole morning in the gym as well.
Better work on those guns.
Big guns. Benny, look, what I love about Benny, he just, every shot is conviction. He hits every shot with conviction. And that's 1-0. Dave did very well. Dave was 3-0 down,
yeah.
Against Chris McKenna, and he came back to beat him 4-3. It was a huge victory. And obviously beat me 3-2 in the last 16. The Ferris wheel.
Ricky Emery was also 3-1 down in his quarterfinal match against Sewan Nika.
Huge win.
And came back to win.
Huge 4-3. Win. Huge win. Sawan's been playing well this weekend. He won the Flyer on Friday night, the $50 comp. And Ricky, huge, come back from 3-0 down. My first time in South Australia, first time in Adelaide. Had a great time so far. So far I've seen the Empire, Pool Hall, McDonald's, and the Sue Blackie joint down the road. And yeah, my hotel, which is beautiful, by the way.
You've probably seen the best tourist attractions of Adelaide.
Yep. And JR's ours, which is a tourist attraction in its own.
Yeah, thank you for sharing that on Facebook for everybody. JR's little morning dance yesterday.
The one thing about JR you'll get is he's good at the dancing.
I think you've been drinking too much this weekend. Your eyesight's gone.
I don't drink.
No, you don't drink.
Shane Chard is just knocking a black in against Glenn Forrest in the Belongs comp. Yes,
the Glenn. Glasser.
The
Glenn
Glasser.
Ferris, the Glasser.
Glenn the Glasser Ferris tried to take out Linda Holly's eyes the other day. He's a violent man.
There's a tip, don't drink Jager bombs without holding your glass in your hand.
Yeah. I've always said Dummy shouldn't be beating up women, but...
It's alright. He's been apologising profusely today since he found out, because he couldn't remember.
Don't know who's left in the Blancs comp. We've got Glenn Ferris against Shane Charles and I think Amelia.
This Glenn and Shane is a semi-final.
Amelia, Jake McCartney, I think he's still going in the Blancs.
I'm not sure who won that match,
yes.
Amelia or Ryan?
I didn't make a mistake. No. Jake McCartney is in the Blancs. But the unfortunate draw of Alec Gavrinidis in the first round, and Alec got up 3-1.
One, yeah.
And then Alec lost in the next round, which was a bit of a shock.
Has been a couple of shock knockouts today.
I think all the big players have drawn each other in.
Yeah, there was a fair few big matchups. Lyndall Hulley and Elise Mabbott being the number one.
Good chance here now for Luigi to get a frame.
He plays really well on these tables. Like, as we said earlier, he qualified for the South Australian state team.
Oh, he made the state team?
He did. A few weekends ago.
It's going to be it's a different South Australian. The chap yesterday, I don't know, they were calling him Jesus. Jake was jealous of him. I think he'd look good with Jake dreadlocks.
You think?
Yeah, it's a good look.
Make that head look even bigger.
Humongous. He wouldn't get out the door.
Was that the first frame, obviously, between Louis and Ricky?
They're obviously taking 30 seconds or a minute.
Jake would like us to switch to his semi-final.
Yeah.
Dan,
I fancy
any chance?
I fancy Amelia to beat him. Or she's been playing really well, actually.
She is one of our younger players in South Australia, improving all the time.
How'd she go in the States?
Not so well, I don't think. Not sure where she finished. I wasn't here. I was in China at the time.
Just name drop there.
Yeah.
I was talking to Mikey Cacciola last night. You obviously went and didn't go as planned.
No, we had a chance to win our first match in the World Teams Championships against Vietnam. 5 all in one match, 6 all in the other, and we blew on both to win 4-2. And then after that, it was all downhill. 6-0 against Singapore and 6-0 against China too.
At least you were consistent.
That's right, we were. At least we lost to the winners.
China went on to
China
win.
2 got on to win, yeah.
China though is just so many like freaks at the minute. I expect in about 10 years time, China with snooker anyway, China will just be.
It's the same in Nineball as well. That if you're in the Chinese team, you get everything paid for to go to all the tournaments.
Yeah.
You get you know a wage every week. It's your job. However, it's pretty tough life. The amount they are forced to practice 8-10 hours a day.
Yeah. Like robots.
You know, like all of their sporting swimmers, everything. You know, it's for some of them, it's a way of life. And there's two girls in Chinese Nineball who both came from poverty and now live, you know, pretty much a life of luxury. So full credit to them for what they do.
It's huge.
But yeah. Very hard to compete with, that's for sure. When we don't get any government backing in any Q sports, let alone make a wage from it.
Yeah, I think obviously there's a chance for a bit more money to be made in pool, but it's difficult when you have to fund your own way to go and represent your country.
It puts a lot more pressure on you.
But it's easy in Ireland. I know, like it's just about making the team and. It's only a nice little 50-euro flight over the water on Ryanair.
Yeah. On 10 minute flight according to Parmore House.
Oh, it's a bit longer than that.
I know it is. Giving us all Australians a hard time when we were posting on Facebook after we got home about our jet lag and trying to tell us that he was jet lagged as well. Flying home to Dublin from Blackpool.
I think there's a difference between being jet lagged and hungover though.
Yeah, well, I did go out with the Irish boys one night.
Oh, really?
And my teammates went out with them a bit more than that, so they do know how to party.
You can't go wrong with an Irishman.
Heard that.
That's why Jesus was Irish.
I say I did have many laughs yesterday having Ronan and Glenn Ferris on my table.
We were lucky to get through.
Yeah, we were.
It was a top table.
Glenn I can't Ferris, remember who top qualified that table.
Linda Holly, Adam Andreat, Phil Jones. I think Linda Holly topped the table if I'm not making a mistake.
In one frame she didn't even get a shot.
She didn't against
Glenn Ferris.
All I know is I played 3 frames and had 3 visits to the table, I think, which is pretty good. And then I didn't win a frame after that.
Lucky everybody was a winner yesterday.
Yeah. That's why they call me Donkey.
Which is lucky for the people that played in it, but for the tournament's sake, it's not good.
I'll definitely be back next year.
Yeah, I don't know if this tournament will continue. The last few years have been very disappointing with the numbers. And I don't really understand.
Has it been an improvement this year?
No. It's less this year, I think, than he had last year by 10 or 20. South Australians have a great tournament. Alec does so much for the game. This place is our headquarters. And players just don't want to support for some reason.
The turnout from South Australia, is up in okay or...?
I think it
doesn't help with the tournament on in Melbourne today, but
no,
in the Golden Queue.
There's a fair few Victorians represented here this weekend. South Australian, like I said, the numbers in South Australians, especially Super League, we have 85 registered members and 35 have entered this tournament. And those 85 are playing in the highest league in this state.
Yeah, why would
have
you
an opportunity
to play against the best? You should be.
You know, it's not just an opportunity to play and have a good weekend. It's an opportunity to support the most successful man in pool in Australia. he puts a lot back into this game with, you know, this venue being our headquarters, coaching that he gives people. And, you know, it's a bit of a slap in the face.
It is. Yeah, he wasn't happy.
The players, and they whinge that there's no tournaments for him to play in, yet they don't support him, and one day they'll be gone, and we won't have anything.
That's it.
So, if you want to play in a tournament, you have to travel to Melbourne, or...
Just turns into an expensive affair then.
Yeah.
Glenn Ferris is equalising there with Shane Charles, the starter frame in the long semi-final.
So I'd like to say, if there's any South Australians watching this live streaming,
you shouldn't be watching it.
Get your shit together and enter next year, or we will find we don't have any tournaments to play in except for ones that will cost us money. Support the game or it's in big trouble.
I'd love to go to Barry some year, but it's difficult because if the flights don't work out and
being a responsible
school teacher myself.
School teacher, perhaps the responsible, I'm not so sure of yet. Don't know you well enough.
What's that supposed to mean?
You're Irish.
That's a good chance for Dave here now. One good pot. He would never hit a woman.
You might get Glenn Ferris on the job.
I'll get Glenn.
Glass me.
He'll glass you. Oh, McCartney has just played a shot there. And it's very uncharacteristic of him. I think he'd still pot that down on the black. Oh, he's got two shots.
Oh, yeah.
That's not good at all.
No. Oh, it is. He doesn't have two shots.
Oh, he doesn't have two shots. He's covered a pocket. He's playing chick pool.
And why wouldn't you when you're playing a chick?
Yeah. Whoa.
Oops.
That was an aggressive shot there, wasn't it? She's going to pot the ball into the middle and move the ball that's over the black, and just missed both and left Jake a very difficult black that he could probably pot with his eyes closed. Like the way Brenton's going around today. Brenton's
but then
got
hang
his
on
eyes
a minute,
closed,
he could have pot that with his eyes closed, but he may have followed it in.
No, he
may have
today.
Been watching you today.
That's a talent that I have.
The match you came from 2-0 down to 2-0, win 3-2.
I was 2-0 down, yeah, and came back.
Thanks for potting the black and following it in.
Potting the white and the black. A straight pot. What an idiot.
I found it quite amusing from where I was standing.
It wasn't very amusing for me.
Oh, Ricky has a good chance to
now.
Make it 1-0.
I guess just maybe stun it and play the black into the middle. Bit of a stun shot, stunning off the rail. What would you do, Linda?
So from here, it's hard to see. It looks like he's lining up in the middle, so from my long distance view of the table, let's get back on it and play it in the middle.
That's what he's going for. Oh, he screwed it back, but should be fairly simple from here to make it 1-1. Tight angle, but I think he's in a good position behind the black. So.
You couldn't have asked for a better position on it, really.
That's it, 1-1. Ben coming in now. Dave, I think, has potted a few, has he? He's on reds. Ben's on yellows. He's got two problem balls, the two on the rails. Oh no, wait, Ben's on the reds. Shows what I know. And he's left himself. Surely he's not thinking about popping that into the corner. If he is, he's drank too much of the champagne I gave him.
Unless he has two shots.
Well, that's the other thing. I haven't been paying attention very well. Ben got two shots.
It's because we were concentrating on Ricky's game.
Jake has just beaten Amelia.
So Jake
is
in the final
of
the long scrum.
Plays the winner of Shane Charles or Glenn Ferris. Glenn the Ferris wheel.
I told you he's got a new name now.
Glenn the Glasser.
it's not a bad shot he just played there.
To me, they're a bit difficult. Those two yellows are kind of...
He's on the one in the middle of them. But he may not get a shot after.
He has to take the one out from here, Glenn, or else I think Shane will punish him.
So if anyone's really wondering why we are now calling Glenn the glasser, because he decided that he would have a Jaeger bomb without holding onto the glass, except for with his mouth, and as he finished it, it slipped out of his mouth, landed on the table, exploded, and all went in my face.
Yep.
Thankfully.
You still look hot though, it's gone.
Thankfully, I didn't get any cuts. It's a lesson for all the boys and girls. If you're going to drink Jaeger bombs,
don't use your hands. Use your hands. It probably didn't happen. It didn't help the fact that it was probably his fucking... Excuse me. His 17th Jaeger bomb of the day.
17. That's probably a bit short.
Few drinks in his Saheed Charmer decided that he wanted to play me for money last night.
Well, that was pretty funny too.
It was really funny. I thought it was hilarious the fact that I won as well.
And I think Sahil was a bit more steady on his feet than you were.
That's true. I'm his captain on there in Tuesday night MMPL, so it's a bit of bragging right there. Oh, what? Not like Ricky to miss that putt there. No harm done though.
I was too engrossed in this Blomskamp semi. Don't know why.
Shane Charles and I. Oh, that's a foul for Shane Charles. It's giving Glenn two shots, two yellows left. Myself and Richie, have you ever met Richie Comiskey? I'm not sure.
Yeah, he came over here one year.
And we decided to play against Shane Charles and someone else for money. But the problem was Richie couldn't walk at the time. And Richie did more singing Garth Brooks songs than playing pool. It was my old cue, he took a chip out of the tip of the cue. It was a messy day. It's a good shot there. Develops both balls. And really now you think it's going to be a McCartney-Ferris final, which might be worth getting a camera onto. Get a camera onto that one. Lynchy says they're not worth it.
You can't say that to me, Mikey Cassiola.
What's Cassiola said? Oh, that's outrageous for a 20-year-old boy to say that. He's a good lad.
It is an Australian thing, it is a term of endearment here.
Yeah, I definitely put him on detention for that one.
Ronan, Mikey loves you.
I love you too, Mikey. With all my heart. He got me in big guns this year, Mikey did. In the loser's side. All I remember is playing a black at one point and potting the white after it. I'm really good at that.
Oh, obviously. Ben chopped his black into the other corner pocket.
He's got two shots.
Oh yeah, two shots.
And that looks like game over, Ben Noonan.
Should stop watching this Blomskamp.
Oh, it's just too good to watch, isn't it? Oh. And Ben Noonan
really
is into the final.
Stuff that up.
I mean, he waits the winner of Luigi Iaro Rossi.
Very solid performance.
Or Ricky Emery.
He will take some stopping.
I think the crowd would like to see a Ricky Emery Ben Noonan final, but
that's the ideal matchup.
Can't write off Luigi. He's had a really good day today. I've never heard of Luigi before. I think he's brothers with Mario.
Like I said, he can't
Michael Cassiola.
And Ricky Emery goes 2-1 up.
Louis leaving Ricky clean runs there through to the black. And good on Kane Weekly for umpiring for one of the losers in the quarterfinals.
Is Kane Weekly related to Grant Weekly?
Yes, his son.
Ah.
Yeah, he just won the state under 15 title a couple of weeks ago.
Jeez, he's a big guy for only under 15.
Yeah.
He's bigger than me, which doesn't say much.
That would not be hard. I'm nearly bigger than you.
Now, come on now, Holly. Don't be going that far.
The Glasser, Glenn Ferris versus Jake the Head McCartney
Glenn
in the Bronx Conf final.
Can barely stand right now. He's it's the battle of the drunks.
The drunk blonks.
The wheel against the head. The wheel versus the head, and is there any chance, any danger? Glenn Ferris is
make
dropping
sure
cues around this here. Yeah, they're going for a match here, Glenn Ferris against McCartney, and no safety is allowed.
You're too late.
Alright, looks like Dan's going to live stream the final of the Blancs Comp.
It might be the... And looks like Glenn is going to be late for yet another match. It's a good job he doesn't have to get a flight for this one.
Richard Leaving just walked in the room this morning as he was called to play.
Yeah. Tell you what, I've had a weekend of living in JR's pocket.
But you're in a hurry to do that again.
Yeah. On Monday night, tomorrow night, we have a in-house match, four-man team event at Potters. Myself, Glenn and JR, Barry Wakefield. Playing against, I don't remember who we're playing, but I think they've got a fancy of their chances. Sitting second in the ladder, but it's not looking good for tomorrow's match.
All hungover and tired. Ricky's missing a couple of out of character.
Not like him at all, is it?
We've got the start of our summer league season tomorrow night. Just looking forward to getting back on the table.
Who's on your team, Wendell?
The Prez. Paul the Prez Morelli. And me. I don't know who else.
That's all you need. Tote hockeys.
We've got a block night tomorrow night, so that means all of the matches are being played out of here. It'll be a good chance to catch up with everyone.
Is there many leagues here in Adelaide?
There's quite a few different associations like there is in Melbourne, but the South Australian Able Association only has one league.
Oh, okay. So what's the interleague like, the interleague when it comes to?
So I guess the equivalent of that would be like the country carnival. So we got teams in that from Broken Hill, from Mildura, always has 32 teams. So
that's
played over
a
long
teams.
Weekend. Yeah. We've had a few players from that. They can qualify the top so many players that don't play in Adelaide in Super League. Those people that couldn't see that massage, it was all legit.
Yeah, I'm not sure, but JR's been held back here. And all of a sudden, the main comp has become the not so main comp. It's a bit of an awkward match here for Ricky and Luigi. It's kind of kind of Luigi's probably favourite at the minute.
In this frame, yeah. It's not as free-flowing as both of them would probably like.
And
both
again,
very aggressive players.
I don't know Ricky that well, but I'd imagine he would rather have kind of an open game.
Well, so would Louis, actually. Both very aggressive attacking players. Back themselves to pop balls from anywhere.
And even the black with that corner pop covered, it's kind of awkward as well. You know, you can still take it into the middle. The Schwarzenegger, the Roth, has joined me beside me. I'm still not speaking to him because he beat me. Get to the chopper.
It's David the Roth. Feel the Roth.
Feed the Roth and he will score.
The boy can eat, let me tell you.
What do you think of... How did you feel your game went, Dave? Yeah. Yeah. Arnold Schwarzenegger or the Roth? I don't know who's stronger. Glenn Ferris here, he just doesn't know what to do. The good thing about Glenn Ferris is it's so easy to talk out of shots. That's one of my passions and one of my pastimes is to talk Glenn Ferris out of shots.
and then he just chooses the wrong shot.
Yeah. Well, he'd be fired up, I'd say, here to play Jake. You know, I think he...
I've had a couple of drinks. They're ticking along quite nicely, so
they
can
are.
Be a pretty animated match already by the sounds of it.
Yeah.
Got all the Vics looking around at them, and all the South Australians are watching the semi. Tell you what, Louis Irossi is so so consistent when it comes to this tournament. He would have made at least the quarters for 5 years, maybe
quite
six.
Impressive.
Yeah, he's always.
Someone said he's made the actual state team this year.
Yeah, he made the state team after not really trying out for about 10 years. But good on him.
It's a very different South Australian state team this year with Nodala and I think Ricky Emery only has to turn up to make the team, isn't that right?
Yeah.
Are you in the team as well?
I'm not. I can't. I've got stuff on.
You're washing your hair that day?
Yeah. No, I already had a spot, but I couldn't go. I've got study and money reasons. So it's just hard to commit to practicing and
studying. Surely you're smart enough as it is.
I tend to, yeah, do a lot of study.
What are you studying now?
Yep. I'm doing a PhD in astrophysics.
And you know what PhD stands for?
Yes, I do.
Ladies, are you single, Roth?
Yes.
Ladies, he's doing a PhD and he's single. Anyone out there, and he can play pool. Everything you want, a man.
Not really sure how to respond to this. I don't think there is a tactful way.
There is no way to respond to that. Just nod and agree.
Yeah.
Ferris wheel has a break. It's a great wide he's got. If he gets a pot, has he potted? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He's potted a red.
Ferris, when he gets excited and he wins a frame, he does the really quick bridge thing, like the horizontal cue, and he does a loop bridge and rubs his cue a few times.
I'm glad you said cue there.
I'm glad I did there too. He's a very good potter.
He is. We were talking about it earlier. He actually won the under 18 World Championship.
Really?
Back in 2002, I think it was.
Yeah, right.
And also won the under 21 championship teams. I'm not sure it was the same year. And he's lost the singles final, under 21s as well.
Yeah, right. How old is he? 30?
Yeah, he's 39.
Okay.
I know what you're thinking. He does look a lot older. It's just the donut bald head he's got going on there.
Is he predominantly 8-ball, or is he...
yeah, he plays snooker. He plays a bit of snooker as well.
Yeah.
I think originally he was a snooker player.
Rightio.
I think he played in a few teams. Himself, yep. And Richie Comiskey.
Yeah, okay.
And Mark Allen, I believe, also. The top two from every group goes through.
Yeah, right.
And the tournament doesn't suffer. Still great suffer, you know. It's still a great tournament, still, you know.
Yeah.
Maybe that needs to be locked up.
You don't miss out on work or anything either.
At the end of the day, like, how many teams? Six teams in it?
Eight? No, SA, Vic, New South Wales, Queensland, ACT, Northern Territory, WA, and Tassie.
Oh, yes, eight.
Could
have maybe everyone play everyone once.
Yeah, you do something like that. You can
get top four and semi-finals.
Yeah, I mean, you can do that and get it over with, like from a Saturday to a Sunday of the following week.
Yeah,
it's definitely possible.
A week, it could even be shortened down to a week, isn't it? Like, it's still huge. It's still a long time.
Just wondering if that can be done. Like
James, the barman behind me, it's his fault why I got so drunk this weekend. I kept telling him to stop serving me, and he just kept serving me.
Hey. Remroid is black for to stay in the tournament.
Even he messes it. Ricky's got a lot of work to do still.
Check out that arm. You can see like 12 different muscles.
Ricky. Is this Ricky?
That's Ricky. Oh. He just slots it in.
3-3.
The guy's a freak. Doesn't play in anything and then just enters the tournament and decides to win it.
One day I want to have arms like him. I think it would look shape at the moment. Kind of short, so have these huge arms. People would just say, what is wrong with that guy?
Quite the Incredible Hulk.
You know? And I'd lose my cute thing that I've got going on. Linda's shaking her head. Short, cute people.
Isn't that right, Dan?
One day us short people are going to rule the world. Someone said that. Who said that? Was that Hitler or... Not that I agree with Hitler's ways.
No.
Let's just make that one clear. Arnold Schwarzenegger didn't either, did he? No!
No!
Ferris wheel is
Glenn Ferris hasn't really played a very good shot here.
No, because, yeah, it's a bit... he used to be okay still, look. Oh, he's...
I might like to try to pod this and then just go off the route, run into the black.
I'm a bit confused why he's walked away from the table. Oh, this guy on the left here. He's trying to see which cue is the straightest. Oh,
that's really straight, mate.
I think you're going to need more than that to help with your game, mate.
I wonder if he'll actually lie on the ground and check the air underneath the cue.
Yeah. Hang on, he'll try another one.
Yep, he's good.
He's good. He's happy with this one.
He selected his...
Maybe, Dan, can we get that? Can we get the camera on his match? He looks good, this guy.
Got to be a highlight. I might try that. Next tournament, I'll put my cue on the ground and roll it. So this frame's ugly. 3-all.
Let's open things up a little bit. Oh, it's over. Ooh. Oh my god. That would have been a terrible way to lose the match.
Yeah.
Glad that I didn't go in. That's made things a wee bit more awkward, hasn't it?
Yeah, frame's horrible.
play first, just rolls that in and should be...
Pretty much all Ricky has to do is to run the red down the rail and then just get his dead red out, pretty much, and he's got control of the frame.
This is the only problem. I don't like Luigi's chances right now. I don't think Ricky wants to go game here, though.
No. He's going to drop this one and land on the back rail and just chip his red out, probably. And the Ferris wheel is over.
Yeah, best of three. Ferris wheel has won the Blancs. Still doesn't get me back the money that I backed him in the Calcutta for.
I was in Geelong like in 2001, and they I didn't qualify, and Velo's come up to us and he's gone, all right, we're gonna have a Calcutta for the Blancs comp, and like yeah, went out like $2 and $4 and stuff. And I think we had like a couple of the great players ended up getting knocked out early, and they went for like $25 or something ridiculous.
Big money.
Yeah. Yeah, if you won the tournament and you backed yourself, you'd get like $90 or something.
Still got the same problem here, Ricky, that ball beside the yellow.
Yeah, digging himself into a hole.
Really doesn't want to keep potting here, because I think Luigi would be happy to see him keep potting.
Yeah. Do you think that yellow in the middle of their three reds goes in the middle? Goes in the right middle?
I think it... Possibly.
So that's probably his key shot. I don't know how straight he is on that yellow, but if he can get down to that cherry in the middle, and then get good Poe on the one near the black, he's got actually a chance of going game.
He really does need to pull something out of here now, though.
Yeah. Oh my god.
It's a good try. That goes into the center. He's got a chance to get on it then.
Yeah, well then he can pop both yellows in the middle of a table in that same middle pocket.
Trying to keep Linda Holly awake beside us here. She's had a lot to drink. She enjoys a drink, doesn't she?
She does.
Yeah, one vodka that's pushing it for today.
Had one whole vodka.
Whoops.
No, I wouldn't have taken that shot myself, but that's why he's in the semi-final, I'm north. Yeah, it should be said, Lindell's done a great job in running the tournament. And then I have to say myself, I've really enjoyed my weekend, and I'll be back again next year, if I'm still alive. Sometimes it's a struggle for me these days.
To stay alive.
Need to learn to swim better in ice cold water. It's not a bad shot, but really Ricky's just got one problem ball here now, that one beside the yellow.
Yeah. And the red closest to the the red that goes in the pocket closest to us, he can use that one to kind of stun over.
Play it
into the
middle.
Yellow near the black, and then he's
I'd imagine he'd be playing that red last.
Yeah.
Take the one in the middle, get up for the top one, and then yeah, you're right. And it's a great chance for him to go for the game now, isn't it?
Yeah. Depends how straight he is on this one. Might have to roll it into the middle.
He's going for it long ways.
Yeah. Nice bounce.
even though he went for that long ways, you still expect him to get it, don't you?
Yeah, he just has that aura about him that he's just going to pot everything. So Louis probably just rolls this yellow down, blocks his pocket, make sure he doesn't actually pot the yellow.
He should be delighted to be getting another shot in this room.
Yeah.
I don't know what he's going for here. No, he's gone for it, yeah, what you've said. He's covered the pocket, but he's left him on the red to the corner, to the middle pocket.
Well, not really sure how much damage he's actually done. I mean, Ricky can probably roll the red in the middle, and then he might have a double on. If he just runs into the yellow, then he's probably got a natural double. But yeah, this might be Ricky's last visit.
The red that he's missed has gone a bit awkward as well.
It's a good shot. He's also knocked a yellow safe.
Glenn Ferris and Brian Collier are having a little kiss. I think they're a cute couple. I don't know who has got the bigger beer belly. This is a key shot now. If you can get this and get on the red up on the top. I don't think you can though.
No,
it's hard to do much with the white here.
Yeah. I mean, he always looks like he's considering something else. Yeah, just gonna move this red off the rail. Probably attempt to have a go, obviously, but nope.
I know.
Sneaker attempt.
I know, Ricky's definitely favorite here.
Yeah.
Unless one of the yellows goes under the black.
Oh. These guys
are going to be long
shopping. By no means is that going to be streamed.
The winner!
Already.
The winner of the blocks!
And the Ferris wheel is looking for a TV right here.
Well done, dude. Congrats.
He's got a few names this weekend. The Glasser, Ferris wheel. Sam.
I won with a glass last night.
We've already talked about that.
Oh, you think the fucker better not have? Are you serious?
Lindell is.
I'm not sure what Louis' plan is. He might be on the yellow in the middle, and he. Yeah.
He's already hit me, ladies
right.
and gentlemen.
He's a
violent,
yellow, Ricky.
Violent man. Violent man, he's just punched me. And he spilt my vodka, which.
Might be able to smack the yellow in the black.
Spilt my vodka, which is not good.
We're all baby.
Got a win, wow. Did not think that went. Anyway.
I did wonder about that. I thought there was a gap underneath it.
This camera angle is really weird, but
huge chance for Luigi here.
It's GG, I reckon. Just slightly.
It's not even happened there, you're pumping.
And if he rolls this in, it's straight. Great chance.
Oof.
He's already snookered himself there.
Jeez. And he's made, did he make the final last time, or was that the year before? He played James Dello a couple of years ago. Congrats to Louis R. Rossi.
Huge win.
Beating a Barry Open champion and defending champion as well.
So Louis and Ben Noonan. Luigi must be is he an Italian?
He's probably Italian. Went for $70 in the Calcutta.
That's a bargain.
Yeah.
Got the final now, Ben Noonan against Luigi Iarossi.
Iarossi,
am I right now?
Iarossi.
Iarossi.
With two S's.
So it's spelt wrong. It's okay, Lynchy's not.
And then check out the paint job. It was on the flyer. Check out the paint job.
Sarah serving drinks behind the bar. I think I want to marry that girl. Just won't speak to me, that's the problem.
Won't blame him.
All right, well, I might jump down there. Yeah. I've got to umpire soon, so...
I'm going to go to the bar for a while. We'll be back for the final.
Enjoy.
These things off, eh?
Hey guys, just quickly, want to congratulate the two finalists, Louis LaRossi, South Australia homegrown, and Ben Noonan from Victoria. Both class players to make this field, make the final of this field, and best of nine, so it's a race to five. I just ask that a bit of respect for the players, okay? While they're playing the game. Fantastic. Thank you. Good luck, boys.
Thank you.
my own. I am back. Here with, again with Lyndall Hulley. And Benoon is 1-0 up against Luigi. Race to 5.
It was a quick out.
It was a quick out, and I am not expecting this to be a long final, even if he wins or loses. Got a Facebook commenter from Colby Poole, Lyndall. She's a good player, Colby, isn't she?
She's great.
She is a good player.
Head case no longer.
How did she go in the Australian singles this year?
This year hasn't been played yet.
Oh, last year. How did she go in that?
In the Australian singles. I do believe she was runner-up.
Runner-up. Not many people go. You'd have to be a superstar to beat her.
Well,
I think she gave Butters a touch up this weekend.
She did. Spoke to her this morning.
Good win.
I wonder if she beat Jamie. She was due to play Jamie in the last eight on the winner's
side. Yeah, it was
the
last eight on the winner's side, yeah.
Golden Q. She did finish 5th to 8th. I saw the post on Facebook of the cash envelope.
It's bragging rights in the house. I think Hunter will be back in his mummy.
She should talk to me.
Graham Wright just came there. He thought he was on his way for commentating. Spare noise. Really. It's a bit hard to get on this last boy. He's asked to play a good. He has to play a good positional shot here.
Stunned off the rail. In his side, just like that.
That is a shot and a half. You've gone a little bit far.
He's hit it too sweet.
Maybe cut the yellow into the corner and then let the white just run by the black and play the black in the same pocket. I think he's actually cutting the yellow into the corner. Oh no,
yeah.
It's a bit disappointing for Ben Larry. He's kind of gifted Luigi that frame.
He did.
Chance for Luigi to get off the mark. Big crowd here cheering on Luigi. They all have to out cheer Sahil Sharma, which is difficult to do. The loudest Indian in the world.
I heard he was a bit loud.
Crowd's fairly diminished here. Everyone's gone home to watch it on the TV.
Why wouldn't you, with such great commentary?
The commentary's amazing.
But it is 8:35. It's a bit late for us South Australians. Go on, sing. Don't just do the dance moves.
All this put together.
Oh. Be very costly. Scratch on the break with all the reds.
You know, I just said it in the last game as well. The way Benny just, everything's just like conviction. Every shot. Like I find sometimes in my own game, when I get down to the last two or three, I start to roll them in, and that's probably my downfall as well. But every shot he plays it with such good conviction. No, you never see him roll the ball. Yeah.
You roll a bull, they miss sometimes. You know, you could hit it perfect and you get a kick or
yeah.
Get a finger mark on a table or something like that. A bit of chalk.
See, like everyone, like that. Like.
Yeah. Oh. And let's just and that play is, that a bit fast.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is called the commentator's curse.
Jumped up out of the shot before he played it.
He did. His head came up a little bit. I think it's because he's drinking that raspberry juice the minute.
Or the champagne that you bought him.
No, he stopped drinking it.
I don't blame him.
He said it didn't work.
He only won 4-0. 4-1, it didn't work.
what I'm looking forward to, Lindell. Getting up from the flight at 10 past 6.
And going to work all day.
And again, going to try teach children.
After no sleep this weekend.
It's fair to say that my lessons won't be very good
tomorrow.
If you
roomed with JR, you're probably too scared to go to sleep.
Oh, you wouldn't. He's a gentle lover, though.
I'll take your word for it.
James Mack have just said, I can't understand your view on commentary. Tough, James. Tough. The main thing is you're still balder than me.
Although you are shorter than me. Brenton just measured us.
But James is one of these guys who still styles his hair even though he's bald. Like, he needs to stop, just shave
it
off.
Got the comb over.
Yeah, just shave it off. Like, he's on my Seppel team as well. One time I had a little bit of a sing-song in Fast Eddies, and James said, it's the first time I've ever understood anything you said. I think it's because the words were coming up on the screen as well for karaoke.
Subtitles.
Subtitles, Colby Poole, subtitles. They do everyone in the world a good.
Oh, that was a little fortunate. Perfection, Graham Wright. That's a new name for 2-1 it.
2-1 to Luigi.
Play position on the perfect position on the black off the inside jaw of the middle pocket.
And I know I'm biased, but I would love to see Ben Nuna win this tournament. I would love it.
You'd love it?
I'd love it.
Love it.
Who do you want to win, Lindell? That's a long pause, ladies and gentlemen. Long pause.
Well, it is a South Australian versus Victorian final, so, you know, my blood is red, so I suppose I have to say South Australia.
I suppose that's a big word there, isn't it?
You're funny. Very funny.
Love you.
With friends like you. Who the hell needs enemies, huh?
So yeah, my response to Jim's makeup is, how do you like them apples? Always the advantage when you're on the commentary, you can say stuff and people really can't answer you back unless they message you. Looking at Danny Lynch here, their favourites for the SEPL would probably be Inkerman Saints, even though they finished fourth. Playing against Graham Klein Cross's team on Wednesday night. And a sank in Mill. Surprised the Sankey didn't come to this tournament. He's a great pool player. You always want Mel on your team.
This has been a quick finish to even the matchup.
And yes, Bendy, too easy, son. Benny is back, and that's what the crowd are saying. Benny's back. Benny is back. The old Benny's back. Big time. It's unmistakable JR's head, isn't it?
Yeah.
Unmistakable. He asked me today, do you think I should wear a red t-shirt or a black one? Say, wear red, because it brings out the colour of his eyes.
You should wear red when you're in the home of the Reds. It's good to see that he's supporting South Australia.
He's a big South Australia fan.
As you would be.
You couldn't get any more diehard Victorian fan than Johor.
No, you couldn't.
He
I was here for the South Australian versus Victorian match last night.
Yeah. How did that feel? How do you like them apples?
Well, you know, South Australia is a defending Australian able champion.
The thing was, like, I commentated on the match and it never looked in doubt.
No, it didn't, did it?
Ben was getting hammered, Glenn was 5-0 down, McCartney and Ricky was a close match.
Yep. So 1-1 with 1-1 with Brenton Collier leading 5-0. Who would have thought South Australia lose from there?
Yeah, and playing shots one-handed.
Yeah, that was to go 5-0. That fired Glenn up somewhat.
Yeah, that would. I think that might have angered Glenn a little bit.
It's always dangerous to give your opponent any extra ammunition. And he played huge from there.
He did play well, yeah. He played terrible in the first few frames, though.
I only came back at about, I think it was 4-0 when I walked back into Empire.
Jake actually said to me, he said, "What? Every time I looked up, you missed an easy black." And he said to himself, "Why did I get this guy to play in the same team as me?"
Yes. Best of 9. It's going to be a quick final. I know that much.
It is, just as well.
Just as well?
Yeah, I need
some people that have to get up at before the sun comes up.
Gotta get up at 5 to get a flight.
Couldn't have, didn't think to take the day off work tomorrow.
Can't know that I'm on this. Us teachers don't sleep. We can't take days off.
No.
Oh, it's important.
You only get 12 weeks holidays a year.
The children are our future.
I work in a school too. I understand this.
James Mech is still trying to get the better of me. Smart shot there by Ben. There's still a bit of work to be done on this frame. First kind of bit of safety we've seen. It was just kind of Luigi on it a couple of times, Ben on it a couple of times.
Yeah. It's been a good final to watch so far.
It has been a good final. Got this habit, I feel like making Mario Brother jokes. Let's hope he has the flower power to win the match.
Lost for words.
Not sure how the Golden Q went today in Melbourne. Interesting to see who won that. If anyone could give me a text or a message on Facebook, that'll be much appreciated. I know Colby finished 5th, I believe. Does that mean that she beat Jamie in the quarterfinals?
I'm unsure. I think she should give us a call.
Should have. There was a couple of shocks in that, actually, from what I was looking at.
Oh, we need to make a correction from Colby. It was double elimination. So she finished 5th to 6th.
Oh,
not
right.
5th to 8th. We're very sorry.
Trust Colby to say she finished 5th though and not 8th.
Miss Hashtag, we're very sorry. you're not bad. Just to show that you definitely aren't a head case anymore.
I think I've seen that text message.
You can see it all you like, it makes no difference.
Last 24 of Golden Q. Colby, Jamie, Glenn, Vases, versus the Hammer. Robbo and Sean Partridge, Josh Boyle, James, Jason Ramsden. Josh Boyle always goes well when he's in these comps, these kind of comps where it's... He's got a... When it's a race to something.
It's a race to something. Usually is in a pool match.
No, like in it. Oh, he got it. He got a vote. He only got one frame against us on Monday night. And he beat Danny Lynch on Tuesday night. Doing a bit of umpiring.
Good on the Roth. Still a head case. You can't make the semis at world titles and still be a head case. And the final of the Australian.
Yeah, yeah.
And be a head case, can you?
No, you can't at all.
Colby Poole, you are a legend.
She's a legend. I played Colby, the first time I've ever played her was in the Dandenong Open last year. It was the last 32 or the last 16. And she beat me. Which is quite upsetting.
Good work, Cobbs.
It's not the first time I've lost a chick either.
No. Won't be the last, I'm sure.
Oh, I've got the Golden Q up now. Well, Glenn Crowe's beating Jamie Stevens and that. So Jamie obviously beat Colby. Jimmy beat Colby 7-5. And the final is on right now. Glenn Crowe against Vic Opalaki. Opalaki. Kind of an unlikely final. Lendl's look at me as if to say, who the hell are they?
I have heard of them. I don't know if I know them.
And Cross is the ginger assassin. Glenn beat Jamie Stevens and Sean Partridge. Vic Opalaki's going very well. He's beat Brett Rogers, he's beat Mark Robertson, and then Steve Gray, and Jamie Stevens. That is huge. Jason Ramsden, and then Sean Partridge. It's a big, big lift. Man, he's done well. Done very well, but I think Glenn Crowe has got two lives against him in the final. Thank you for that, Steve Jameson.
Apparently Colby let Jamie off in their last eight match.
Yeah.
The winner's side.
I'd like to hear Jamie's version.
Mikey Cassiola.
He's on it again.
You really, really can't say that to me.
That's outrageous, Mikey. I used to think you were a nice kid. You cannot say that to a woman.
I would never, ever think of saying that to you. Terrible.
I can't believe children his age know those words.
No, he probably can't.
Oh, I was looking forward to that match last night. Yeah, Michael Cattiola and Glenn Ferris. It would have been a good game.
It would have.
I think Glenn's.
What happened there, Mikey?
Glenn's brains were fried after playing Brenton.
Oh, to come back from 5-0 down.
That's a great win from Luigi. 3-3.
Even it up. 3-0.
3-3 race to 5. I forgot there was even a game on. I got confused there. Thought I was just up here having a chat. That's what vodka does to you.
Trying to read my messages. Good work, Colt. Whose version's more accurate? Accurate. Yours or...
Thank you, Stacey Vine. I am not one of those. For you Aussies, there's a big match on tonight. Donegal against Dublin, the All-Ireland semi-final. It's on 7, mate. Should be a good game. Giving a bit of a shout-out here to Donegal. Hopefully we beat the Dubs. I asked Alec earlier, I said, do you have 7 mates here? And he said, yeah, I've got 7 or 8 mates. Said, really? What a pathetic joke. Couldn't believe it.
I wasn't listening to you.
It's all right, Pat.
Pet.
So back to the match here. That yellow inside the red is a bit of a problem here for Ben. I think Ben is on reds, right? Yeah, he is. Again, just gets down effortless, rolls it in. Doesn't put... He's got an opportunity now to knock the red out. And he's got 2 shots as well.
Oh, just missed it.
He's missed it, but still not much harm done. He can still take the red up to the top corner if he gets on it, okay.
He's trying to pull the red off the yellow.
Oh, he's put a double.
Oh, that's a bit of a stiff kiss. Combo looks like it's on in the middle pocket.
It's definitely on, it's a plant, yeah.
It's a very stiff kiss there.
You know what, he's still got a good chance here to go 4-3 up, because he takes on the long pot. It's game over.
Certainly should be.
Great pot. Great Paul. Bit of a cheer there from Sahil Sharma. He was on a date today, Sahil was.
Mikey, agreed.
Lindell here is spending more time on her phone than commenting.
There's nothing new there.
Really here, the only difficult ball is the black here for Ben. It's a great chance to win the match and win the tournament.
Network.
So Ben Noonan here, two balls away from winning the Empire Johnny Walker Classic.
And black's not going to be easy.
He has to play. He can't really play the yellow into the middle with pace. It's difficult to do because he's into the middle pocket. Joy, but he has to really play it that way, which makes it a lot harder. Dangerous thing here when you've got a microphone, isn't it?
Can be. It's all good. That's why we get paid the big bucks, because we got the microphone.
Yeah. That's it. Pet.
Can't say what I'd like to see, because Dan might censor me.
Well, if he can't get subtitles going for me, he's not going to be able to censor things.
You can't.
That's got to be the next thing he's had to do. Get the subtitles going, Dan.
From all accounts, people need him when they're listening to you. Oh, Benny. Oh.
Benny. Benny, big time. And I'm hoping that is not something that he's going to regret.
No, he puts the ball in the corner and moves the red on the side rail.
And he's still got that ball. By the middle pocket, it's a bit awkward as well.
It's Louis's break if it gets to 4-all.
That's not a very good shot at all. Well, it's not worked out that well. You can roll this one now down. I think then he might have to take on a plant if he goes for that. Excellent shot. Expect Luigi to clear up from here.
Should do.
Oh wow. Oof. Almost missed that one. Almost missed that. Still on it. And it looks like we're gonna come to a one frame, final frame decider.
Yeah. It'll come down to the break. 4-0.
It all comes down to the breaking. Benny will be a bit disappointed. He got a shot in the black, you know, but.
It wasn't a great shot though.
Yeah, it was tough to get on it, but I still feel like he had an out on and.
It's a bit stiff that he scratched in the middle pocket.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Didn't miss the black in the middle by much.
Look at the physique of JR there sitting down.
Do I have to?
Just a guy that. You know, I wish that I had a body like his.
If you work hard enough, you probably can.
Never be able to drink enough though.
You're only about a foot shorter than him.
Oh, my fucking...
About 2 foot. Excuse my language. This Luigi now to break.
Brett Neiman. Or myself.
I think I had him in the Calcutta actually, he was in my grip.
Chopped it up.
Shot now, Ben is probably going to take the red down the rail. He's just about planning his shots now here for Ben.
There's a bit
not ideal. Still got the red to the middle, but he's got to go around the cushions. And he's obviously played that a lot better than I can play it, and now he's just a matter of rolling in the red, and he can get close to the black. So this is it. Ben Noonan, a black to win the Empire Classic. And he's got it.
Great shot on a black.
Huge win.
Big out.
Ben
Not
Noonan.
The time for a dry break. 4 all in the final of a tournament.
And it's caught really, really close, Luigi. Still should be proud of how he's done. He's done really well in the tournament. And
he has.
No shame in that, but Ben Noonan, congratulations.
Goodness sakes, South Australia lose to Victoria twice in one weekend.
Yeah.
What is with that?
It's a sign of things to come in the Nationals, perhaps.
Or maybe it's not.
That's a great win for Ben Noonan. His first tournament win in 4 years. Nobody will begrudge him of that.
Played very solid and all day.
Yeah. And after getting beat 7-1 by De La Honte last night in the money match, you think he didn't have it in him.
He had a couple of close ones. He, I think it was the last 16, he won 3-2. So
against Nathan.
Against Nathan, yeah. Yeah. Good on him. Good to see that he's back in the game and in the winner's circle. Congratulations, Ben.
That's it from us here at Cueball TV. I hope you've enjoyed watching the final here, this tournament, and hopefully we'll see you guys here this tournament next year and not sitting at home watching.
Tables, there's countless people helped me out in preparation for the event. My wife Lynn, doing the paperwork and finding these lovely trophies, and thank you. And thank you, our major sponsor, Johnny Walker, who contributed some funds towards the prize money. So, in saying that, I'd like to congratulate Louis for making the final. Fantastic effort again. Louis made the state team in South Australia. Made it a while ago, and he's come back and made it again. So, and we saw the form there that's put him in that team, and we wish him all the best at the Nationals. So, well done, Louis.